Hey guys, Colleen here, DIYer behind LemonThistle.com.
Today I am so excited to share our entryway DIYs with you guys. So I have three different projects that I made for this entryway exterior reveal that I shared in the fall. I will link the full reveal if you are looking for information on the doors, the siding, the mailbox, all that sort of thing. For this video, I'm just sharing how to make the wreath on the door, the hand lettered mat, and the modern address sign there.
Before we get into it, if you have not yet subscribed to my channel, I would so love it if you did that below so you don't miss out on any more DIY or home decor videos.
All right, so the first of the DIYs is this simple, minimal wreath with wild grasses. So I went on a walk with a friend and we got these grasses. And all I am doing here is taking a simple brass hoop. I found this at the dollar store for just a few dollars. And I am hot gluing the grasses right onto the wreath. Just keep cutting the grasses down to size and gluing them on all the way around, and then add in any more grasses where you feel like it's a little bit bare to get an even sizing the whole way around. Now, if you wanted a chunkier wreath, something a little bit less minimal, you could totally get a wreath form that is thicker just to start with, and then start covering that with the grasses. I really wanted it to be super simple and not too heavy, so that's why I went with such a thin wreath form, and I love the way that that turned out. All right, next up is my address sign, and I'm gonna spend the most amount of time on this one because it's the one I'm most excited about. So I actually made this address sign using wood and my Cricut Maker. The Cricut Maker can cut basswood up to a certain thickness using the knife blade. So here I'm using the Cricut basswood, and I put the knife blade into my Cricut Maker and I got to cutting. Now, before I show you how to actually put the thing together, I wanna talk to you about designing it. I wrote a whole blog post about that. So if you're interested in the tech side of designing a sign like this in Cricut Design Space, I will link that down below, but it is just using basic square shape stretched to a rectangle, and then I'm slicing it with the font that I laid over top. Super simple, nothing fancy here. Other tips for cutting wood on your Cricut Maker, other than using the knife blade, are to move the star wheels all the way over to the side so that they don't indent the wood as you're cutting, and to tape down your wood onto your mat just so it doesn't shift around at all. Once it's cut, it can pop out super easily, or you might run into a couple areas that are just a little bit stuck, like some of the wood wasn't totally cut through. So in that case, I just use my craft knife and I run it through the cut that's there just to break any last little bits that are stuck together here. So you can see that I'm using a couple different pieces of wood here. This is because I wanted it to be larger than the 12 inches that the base wood comes in. So to make it stronger, I am using two layers and I've separated them in different spots so that it will be stronger. Not that it's going anywhere, it's going to be attached to the house, but I just thought that this would provide a little bit of extra strength. So I am gluing them together. I am using no more nails. You could use any glue here, wood glue would be great. And I'm just making sure that they are lined up as best as possible between them. And then I'm gonna put books on top, and I left this overnight to dry. After it's totally dry, I'm gonna come back in and I'm gonna wood fill and I'm gonna sand it. So even if it doesn't perfectly line up, that's okay. And then it was time to finish it. So I chose to use a metal paint first, and I did this just for texture. I was really going for the metal look, even though it's a wood sign. And so after I did this metal paint, then I went in and I spray painted it with a matte black spray paint and did a few coats of clear matte protector spray. It has been up on our house since the fall, so it's been out all winter and we haven't had any issues with it. It's holding up really beautifully. Okay, and the third but final DIY is this fun address mat. So if you've been following Lemon Thistle for a while, this may not be a new DIY to you. I have done hand lettered mats before. I really love the way that they look, and they actually hold up really well when you do it this way. So the last one that I had held up over a year, and this one we put up in the fall, and it's been out all winter with our family of six trucking in and out over it. So to do the hand lettered mat like this on core, I just use a multi-surface acrylic craft paint, and I use this fine tip squeeze bottle to lay it down on the mat. I find that it takes 2 lines of paint per letter to get a nice consistent size, and then I push the paint down into the core mat using a paintbrush. Now, last time that I did this, I'll link the video there if you would like a slower tutorial for this, but I used a kid's craft paintbrush and that worked really well because it doesn't fray too much. I didn't have one this time, so I took a normal craft paintbrush and I trimmed the bristles down so that they were shorter and stiffer. All right, so those are the 3 DIYs that I made for this exterior entry reveal, and I so hope that you enjoyed them. I love adding DIY touches to any space, no matter how small. It helps me get a higher end look for a more affordable price, and it's totally customizable to our family. I hope that this inspires you to create some DIYs for your own home.
Thank you so much for watching. I hope that you enjoyed this video. If you did, make sure to give it a thumbs up and subscribe so you don't miss out on any more DIY or home decor videos. We'll see you next time.